Hola guys and girls, and welcome to week 5 of the UPBA. We are up against Aqua and their Chicago Strength Sap. Scary team in multiple ways. The main reason is, or one reason is mainly the Mew. And as you know, Mew does everything. So there's a lot of scouting going to be in them having the match to see what this Mew is going to do. And yeah, I'm mostly expecting defensive because their team is very weak to Zygarde. And defensive Mew is really the only thing they could have. And yeah, other than that, Diggersby and Terrakion are very scary offensive core. Both are checked by Skarmory, but that's kind of the problem because Skarmory will have trouble checking both of them consistently. If one of them is banded, they might do it Kyomi if they go for the right move and stuff like that. But yeah, that's mainly the team. Let's see what we will find once we have the team in front of us. So yeah, we'll cut to them. Okay, here we are with the match. They brought Mew, Starmie, Registeel, no Terrakion, I'm a fan of that. Talonflame, okay, Talonflame made sense because something for Volcarona had to be there. It was either the Talonflame or... I actually don't know what else on the team, let me look at it. Yeah, Talonflame or stuff like the Rotom Heat, I was expecting for that. And Zerkatree, okay. Okay, okay, okay. Okay, yeah, like I said, I was expecting a lot, so it's not like I can tell these are exactly the six I think Aqua would bring. But yeah, bringing my team, I have Choice Scarf, Physical Owl, then Choice Banded Zygarde, Fist Defensive Skarmory, then Quiver Dance, two attacks substitute Volcarona. I need to weaken the Registeel down to fire attacks, and then Physical, the Physical Defensive. What you call it, Uxie with Heal Bell, and then specially defensive Jolteon, which was mainly there for Zerkatree, for example, which very nice that it brings it. It's a Diggersby, so sadly, like I was on the fence, maybe Diggersby wouldn't come, but yeah, that means I can't Wolf Throne because Wolf is the only attack I have, only other thing I have is the Thingamajigger. But yeah, lead-wise, I think I just lead with my Uxie. I can U-turn out with anything. I need to be quick because I only have 8 seconds left. Come on. Let's go. We have the team, they're done. Like I said, I'm leading with Uxie, can U-turn out with a lot, can take a lot of hits, and just see what's happening. I have Giga Drain on Uxie as well for the Diggersby, because like I said, I brought Uxie kind of as a secondary check to his physical offensive mons, because as mentioned before, yeah, Skarmory will have trouble dealing with both Diggersby and Terrakion if both would have come. Now that only one of them is there, I can a bit more reckless with my Uxie, I want to say. They lead with Mew. Yeah, now it's scouting time, honestly. No idea what they want to do. I'm just gonna U-turn. This is exactly what we want to see. So Mew is faster and has taunt. That's good to know. Let's see how much we are doing with the U-turn. Taunt. That does 20-ish percent, I want to say. U-turn looks like max HP Mew. Okay. Great news on that regard. And I could just go right into... Honestly, I just go right into all and U-turn once more. We don't know what the item yet. Could be Cobra or something like that. I'm honestly just going to U-turn again because Aqua is either going to switch out or switch into Diggersby or something like that. Okay, yeah, switches out. Nice, so we get momentum there. And Tin Titans should be the Registeel. Yeah, indeed the Registeel. And versus that, I'm just gonna go hard into my Banded Zygarde. Well, that is close to nothing. Because even though if this boy is Ice Punch or shenanigans like this, like I said, I need to weaken this to be able to sweep with my Volcarona. So I'm fine. I could go to this as well and start getting off spikes. To be honest, I like that more. To be honest, because I don't think Earthquake will Oko a Registeel. Because looking Fistef, leftovers. We see. But look at that. Yeah, even 1000 arrows is like 70 to 80 to not even fist death. So yeah, I won't Oko that. So lefties on that. And yeah, Aqua might get up rocks here. I'm just spiking. Because spikes do a lot versus this team. Aqua only has Talonflame, which is not affected by that, barring they have boots on something. Talonflame right away, okay. That's fine with me versus that. I am just gonna go straight into Uxie. This Talonflame might be mixed with Overheat shenanigans, because obviously Fire Blast wouldn't do a whole lot to me. Could go into this guy as well. I think playing it safe, just going into Uxie, is the... I need to stop, definitely healthy. This game is already going pretty fast. I could go into Jolteon as well. Jolteon is slower than Talonflame though, I'm not that bulky. I think just Uxie is the safest bet. This thing starts setting up. I do have a Choice Scarf O, which is faster. Wait, am I faster, actually? Will-O-Wisp, okay. Will-O. I'm fine with that, I have Heal Bell on this guy. Will-O. Could just go straight for the Heal Bell, honestly. And I'll just throw off one Psychic. Just play it safe. Throw off one Psychic, and let's see how much we can do with this Talonflame. Breaking the Gale Wings is gonna be important. There's the Taunt. So this is a breaking Talonflame, bulky Talonflame most likely, with Roost as well, I'm assuming. Taunt, yeah, that shouldn't be too much, doing too much, yeah, that's like 40%. I'm just U-turning after that. If Aqua decides to Roost, they are going to be faster, and that means my U-turn will hit after, and that means the Gale Wings will be broken. It seems they are expecting rocks from us, yeah, there's the Roost. Figured as much, and then like bird move as last, I assume. The brave bird. So let's actually check something. Yeah, that sadly won't be doing enough. So how do we do this the best way? I think just going Jolteon. Because with that set, I assume brave bird as last move. I'm not too scared of this thing, and I just throw off a Toxic, question mark? Or Volt Switch. If Diggersby happens to become in, that's not too big of a problem, I think. I go for Volt Switch. If Diggersby comes in, I can... I'm expecting to Choice Bunny. Yeah, there's the Bunny. That makes sense. Like I said, I'm expecting Choice. Spikes be taken. I will Protect right here. Because I'm expecting Choice. SD won't be able to sweep me yet, so I think I'm rather safe, even a setup is happening right here. I'm just scouting what happens. And we see U-turn, okay. Yeah, that means I can stay in, just Volt Switch. Or I could switch. What could I do that to... Not really much. Honestly, just throw off a Toxic and see what happens there. If he's... I want to know if this Diggersby, okay, looks to be banded, if it's slower than me. That means this U-turn will hurt. I was expecting kind of Scarf there. Let's see, U-turn happens. Does... Yeah, that does... let's see, 63. 63 to my Bolty Jolteon with Diggersby. What item are we talking right here? U-turn. 63 damage. That's not too much, to be honest. No, that's not... That's not Life Orb. That's not Bandit. That is... Jolly non-boosting item, but slower than my Jolteon? Okay, U-turn. Assault Vest, maybe? It could be Assault Vest, for all I know. I'm just gonna Volt Switch. Just gonna Volt Switch out here. Do some Chirp. And go back into Scarm. Some Chirp. But yeah, that's non-boosting item, non-attack boosting item, Diggersby. So a bit surprised. Bit definitely surprised there. Could have... Maybe the Diggersby's not choiced. Could be the case. So, I expect rocks right here or something like that. I just go into my Scarm. Yeah, rocks is the... I expect the most to happen right here, which would be fine. Rock Tomb, actually, okay. So prepared for my Volcarona. Rock Tomb. So I'm slower now. I mean, I don't think I'm a slower now already. Skarmory is a decent amount faster than. Might still be faster than this. Do I just get a second layer of spikes? I think I go for one body press here. Just some chip damage with a body press on stuff. Could double as... I mean, now it already clicked Body Press, but I could have doubled predicting the Talonflame to come in. Yeah, there's Talonflame. Doesn't have a nickname! Akra, what's wrong with you? Why does this thing doesn't have a nickname? I don't think this this thing's on a flame buddy. So I'm not too worried here. So, and knowing what this thing's set is, I'm just going back into my Jolteon. Will-O-Wisp is the worst what could happen. Roost will most likely happen. I'm thinking Willow, Taunt, or Roost here. Brave Bird wouldn't make a whole lot of sense. There's the Taunt again. Back into the Jolt. And I just Voltage once more. Because with Digaspy I can protect once more, get some more chip damage, take more lefties. I'm not too worried. Like I said, I'm not worried about the Digaspy coming in. So that's why I'm world switching. This time I will switch out though. I will protect once to scout, like I said, but I will switch out to into Skarmory because the Digaspy might not be choice into a move. But yeah, it's fine. This guy is getting chipped down. I'm once again going to protect the scout. But then I'm going to go switch out into Skarmory. What's this guy? Sword Stance, U-turn. I mean, last time I was surprised about Sword Stance. I'm going to protect, even though it's obvious. I can't protect, I'm taunted. Haha! Good thing it showed here. Yeah, I'm gonna... Fire Punch might happen... But it's not boosting item, so I'm not scared of Skarmory. Because if not boosting item, my Skarm should be able to take the Fire Punches. Let's see. U-turn might be the obvious thing which happens here. But with my... Yeah, there's U-turn. But yeah, it should... Yeah, there's all leftovers back. And like I said, with Toxic and Spikes and all the shenanigans, I'm feeling safe with these cycles we are currently locked in with like Talonflame, Jolteon, Digaspy, Skarmory. Like if this cycle continues, I will win sooner or later since I have Feather Zap and they don't. Zerg might come in here, but like I said, Jolteon is still a good switch to Zerg as well. We see the Starmie. Okay, so Rapid Spin might be what's happening here. Be it as it may, that the Rapid Spin is rather obvious, I think I just go straight into my Pet Shop here. Because it's, might happen as well, but I am Scarf, so I am faster than this thing. I am indeed faster than this thing. And if Water Move I take as well, Ice Beam might be the scary thing. Yeah, there's the Ice Beam. Could have gone Jolteon there, but how much damage are we talking here? That's a lot. But I should be faster. Barring it's Scarf, and if it's Scarf, that's good knowledge for sure. That is good knowledge for sure. I'm just gonna U-turn. I am faster than a Starmie with my Owl. Starmie. Yeah, buying we see Scarf right now, like I said. But Scarf, see this thing, Scarf would be good knowledge for us. Ice Beam. How much damage? Let's see. Like, it's not Life Orb. Yeah, it's not Scarf, nice. So you get nice damage there. And then on the most likely... I mean, anything could happen here. Psychic, shenanigans, anything could happen here. I think I just go into my... Jolteon is a bit deaf, but doesn't really like taking the hit. Could go into Uxie. I mean, if I need Jolteon still healthy. Like I said, any move could happen here. Psychic, I'm going to my Uxie. Because Uxie is, like I said, Uxie is expendable. So far, the only thing I would need to heal well for is Uxie itself. There's the Ice Beam again. Okay, maybe try Specs. But no, the damage would have killed my Owl if that wouldn't try Specs. And then I U-turn again. I just U-turn again. Like I said, Rapid Spin might happen right here, but that's fine. Like I said, that's only one spike. Flip Turn. Didn't even know this thing gets flip turn, to be fair. That's new for me. But yeah, it doesn't do a whole lot of damage, and I guaranteed get momentum here. On anything. The info is out there that I'm Scarf Owl, so that's out there. That's common knowledge now. Everyone knows that. But would they even have space for a Rapid Spin then? Ice Beam, Flip Turn, Water Move, one kind of stab, I'm expecting. Like Water, well, Psychic Move, and then Rapid Spin, maybe? Nah, could maybe fit. Still no idea what item though. The only item I know so far is Leftovers on Registeer. Everything else is still a secret. There's Big Kahuna. We U-turn on that. Let's see. Could just go to this fire for Leaf Blade? Question mark? No. Not really sure if I want to do that. Since we know it's... it might be still Scarf, but why is it slower than my Jolteon? That would make no sense. I could go safe and go just go Skarm. Let's play it safe, I think. Okay, let's don't want to be offensive. Let's be offensive. Pet Shop is faster than my Jolteon, so it's definitely faster than this guy as well. Now we just fire off a knockoff this time. Because knockoff could kill the... should kill the bunny from here, right? Diggersby is the name. Knockoff should be doing like 40%, right? Right? Ugh, not guaranteed. Not guaranteed, actually. I'm still going for it. It will die to knockoff plus toxic, and then Jolteon can free Volt Switch, so definitely take that. There's Talonflame. Getting rid of whatever item this thing had is nice as well. Like I said, I don't think this is Flame Buddy. And we do get rid of Heavy Duty Boots. Yeah, it's Boots. That makes sense. That of course makes sense. Could have seen that coming, to be fair. And back into Jolteon we go. So it was Boots. I mean, I don't have Stealth Rock on the team, by the way, if you didn't notice. Because looking at the team, there was not whole... like, the team was more hurt by spikes. The only thing mons which are hurt more by rocks would potentially be the Talonflame and the Rotom, and on both I would expect Boots. That's why I don't have the Fingermagicka. There's the Brave Bird, that shouldn't be too much, since it's a more bulky Talonflame, yeah. And once again, I'm just going for the Wolf Switch. I'm just going for the Wolf Switch. Diggersby comes in, fine with me. We, like I said, this cycle, it works for me. Tintines, okay, no. It is the Rage Steel. So we are out of the cycle a little bit at least. And let's see, this damage, is this a crit? Okay, that did like 20%, I want to say. Like 20, 15%, something around that. That means Fist Death Rage Steel, right? That means Fist Death Rage Steel, because Wolf Switch, yeah, should be not doing that to Spideff. I think I'm fine with just going back to Skarm, to be honest. Because it's not in Zygarde range yet. Sadly, still not in Zygarde range. I'll just fire off a Body Press here. Weaken is the same thing. Body Press, yeah. Multiple spikes could work out in my favor, but I don't really need it. Do not really need it too much. Which might be Talonflame again. Yeah, there's Talonflame again. It's still a critical offense that this thing still doesn't have. It doesn't have a nickname. Very upset with that. Like I said, I'm not scared of being burned. This thing should be the Thingamajigger. I think Jolteon is just safe and then Wish up. Because I still need Jolteon healthy, at least a little bit. Like I said, this cycle is working my favor. Okay, we see a double. Expecting Austrian X-Mass, that's Zergatree. Why would you go to Zergatree when I have... But Jolteon is my switch in. I don't really know what they predicted there. But Jolteon works for me. I'm just going to throw a Toxic on this. Just going to throw a Toxic here. If Big Kahuna comes in, like I said, we are fine with this circle. Okay, what damage do we see? Like I said, I'm Spideff. What is he? Energy Ball, Dazzling Gleam. What move are we talking here? Calm Mind, CM. Okay. CM, Circuitry. So plus, let's give it a plus one boost. Energy Ball with Jolteon is not even a Twit KO. So it's not speed boosting. It's not speed boosting item. Do I just wish right here? I'm faster. So it's going for... I don't really know what's going for here. I go for protect. I go for one protect. Because at plus two, it still doesn't kill me. Yeah. At plus two, it still doesn't kill me. And after that, I can still go for a wish. Death and Gleam. That works. Like, that was a good risk there. Could have gone a second Calm Mind. But now I can go for Wish after that and just chip this thing down. Let's see, what is my switch into D-Gleam? Volcarona would be my switch into a D-Gleam. Let's go for one Wish. Discharge. Okay, that's that of course heals me. That's nice. I take that. Thank you. Probably expected to switch out there. This time I'm gonna. Is a plus one discharge killing my Volcarona? Of course, it could. What you call it? Yeah, it could kill my Volcarona. Oh, that's plus two. Never mind. Plus one. No. If modest. No. Still not. So yeah, I'm volt switching into Volcarona here. Oh, switches actually. Okay. Back into the Big Kahuna? Yeah, back into Big Kahuna. Bulky Jolteon definitely putting in the work, currently earning the title of the thumbnail if the game keeps going like this. Dealing with the Diggersby indirectly. And dealing with the Zerkity and the Talonflame and Starmie as well. Like I said, the only thing I don't beat with this is the Registry and the Mew, I don't know. Protect once, get some free toxic damage, there's U-turn. That means, like I said, I don't know if it's this choice cap or not. I'm gonna switch out. Like I said, I'm not risking my Jolteon because like I just mentioned, it's super useful in this match. So if he wants to show that he's not choice, then he can do that, but not with my Jolteon. Not versus my Jolteon. There we go. I knew it. Bam. Not fooling the master. I'm sorry. And Big Kahuna's down. That means free Volt Switches. There we go. Like I said, I knew something was up when this guy was not banded, but slower than my Jolteon. Something was up there. And yeah, I'm just going back to Jolteon. Like, what did we lose here? Not too much. There's a Gleam, won't be doing too lot. Back in Jolteon, here we go. Energy Ball, yeah, that's not even plus one. I can just free the Wish. Yeah, it's kind of funny, like in the first power rankings, like it was going on, like how defensive my team is, and now I'm using even my offensive mons like Jolteon defensively. So, if your team is not defensive, like it's already super defensive, why not make it more defensive? But yeah, I'm wishing right here. CM might happen, another energy ball. Calm mind, no. CM's happening, yeah. So it's at plus one now. Like I said, and now I can just the protect is obvious. The protect is the obvious play here, so I think I'm just gonna volt switch. Is there anything which hurts me if I volt switch here? Oh, I can just protect and then volt switch, right? Yeah, I can just protect here, then volt switch and kill this thing because toxic does the damage. There's like no need to do fancy plays and volt switch into Volcarona and Desert Gleam or something like that. Okay, on the protect, they are switching out again. This is just a free world switch. I think Aqua's a bit panicking here with all these switches. I think that's usually as a sign of panic. If like you see a lot of weird switches happening which don't really accomplish much. I mean, to be fair, it seems to me you can't beat this Jolteon, because otherwise Mew would have come in a long time ago. And that means, oh wait, Diggersby is not dead. Let me cross that off. Don't know what's actually what's happening here, but now this is Zygarde range, so I would just go into Zygarde. Now this is Zygarde range, I can just fire off 1,000 arrows. It's safe for Thunderbolt as well, a Thunder Wave if that's happening. Rock Tomb, yeah, that's fine. I'm not gonna be slower than this. And Thousand Arrows will not. Oh, the Mew is still there, so it will not claim him one necessarily. Depends on still how bulky the Mew is. But Thousand Arrows will kill this this Red Steel. But yeah, Jolteon and Skarmory and my crew did a very good job at chipping down the team. Now Bandit Zygarde and Molokona can start sucking up the slack. So, we finally see Thanos. Like, how much damage are we talking with this Thousand Arrows? Oh, Boots! Okay, it's Boots Mew. Okay, that's a two hit. Obviously, Willow could happen right here. Very likely happen right here. Let's go into Volcarona. Don't think this is... At worst, it's a speed tie. If this thing has a rock move or something like that. But I'm expecting the Willow to happen right here. Or Ice Beam. Yeah, that's the Ice Beam. Okay. The Ice Beam. I guess I could have a rock move. Could have a rock move. It could win this. I mean, I'm not more XP to be fair. But since it's more bulky Mew, I don't expect it to be super fast. Like I said, I could lose my Volcarona here, but that would actually fine with me. Toxic. Ooh, and misses. That hurts. Hurts, hurts, hurts for sure. Don't know much of it matters in the long run, but definitely hurts. So it's to be fair, like, it definitely would have. Like I said, it's difficult to tell. But I mean, every hex, every miss you get hurts. But we'll see. There's the Talonflame. Yeah, I'm just going back into Jolteon. Like I said, because even if my Volcarona would be toxic right now, I would still go into Jolteon, do this, and I still have Heal Bell on my Uxie. There's the BB, and I can just Volt Switch. Bulky Jolteon for the win. Honestly, yeah, that's definitely thumbnail worthy. Jolteon beating like close to everything. The Diggersby die to Toxic, or was it a move? Did this is a kill for Jolteon? Actually, don't know. What was cancelled? Oh, was it timed? Did we timer? Did we time out? Oh, I didn't look at that. God damn it! I didn't want to time out. Rap. Crap. 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 Oh wait, did they? Forfeit. I don't know. I will tell you probably in the last match. I will end the video right here. GG to Aqua. Definitely check out their channel. Check out the content. But yeah, that's all for me. I will see you another time. Ciao.